What does theater have to talk about?
To talk about the everyday life and to talk about the world we live in. And especially to talk about the things that people either don't want to pay attention or they want to hide under the carpet or minimize or ignore.
How would you describe Romanian theater?
I think it's a mix. I think it's changing, which is good, but I also think there's not much space for independent theater, for small companies and new work. The subsidized theater is very conservatory, and most of their productions are actually productions that are supposed to be commercial, so that have no place in the theater and in this type of theater. And I also think that theater should relate more to the community that it's part of and to be connected to that community and respond to its needs and adapt and create strategies and programs related to that world, that micro world that they're part of.
Mm-hmm. What is political theater?
I think political theater is a theater that addresses issues and topics and problems that need an urgent solving. And what I think it's interesting is that the type of analysis that can be done in the theater is very different than a journalistic analysis or what happens in media. So you can get a better perspective and also a contextualization of the topic that is debated. So that's why I think political theater is something that we actually need a lot.
Mm-hmm. Is all theater political?
I think all art is political, and I think it should be political because it's about how we negotiate and renegotiate our life and our perspective on the world we live in and how we adapt and evolve, basically.
Mm-hmm. In your case, can the role of the author be split up from the role of the director?
Not so much. I mean, not so far. Most of the plays that I wrote, I directed myself, and I think that's also because the writing process is part of the creating of the performance, and I mostly write for the actors I work with, and a lot of stuff is based on their biographies because I want the performers to own the performance and be about themselves, and I think that gives you an extra strength to fight the fight.
Mm-hmm. How do you describe your writing?
I like to think of it as adapting and flexible to the project or the community or the company that I work with, and I'm aiming even the structure or the form or what the instruments that I'm using in creating the play are always adapted to the specific project I'm working on.
Mm-hmm. What does Antisocial talk about?
About power, of course. And about the two things that trigger me and were like the source of energy in writing it were the fact that the teachers were more concerned about saving the prestige and the public image of the high school on one hand, and then this whole thing with authority and the fact that they're not aware of the fact that Facebook is actually a place where we can finally negotiate things from equal positions, both teachers, students, and parents, and they weren't smart enough to take advantage of that and transform that into an educational instrument, and their focus was to punish people. So it's about a bad education system that keeps going and some students that had the guts to fight that.
Mm-hmm. And why did you decide your characters were named after the actors?
As I was saying a bit earlier, I think a performance is stronger if it's about the actors that are actually performing it and not have that distance. I also worked a lot with in productions where I had community members working together with professional actors And I think it's something I got from there, and it's about the authenticity and about giving them an extra power in terms of relating to an audience and communicating their message.